On the demand side, you're going to see more and more demand capable technologies. One of the technologies that I think you're going to see, in addition to software that I've discussed, is you're also going to see definitely storage. And there's a number of companies that are developing consumer scale storage that will, I think, be cost effective to allow consumers to do things like put in a solar PV system and utilize that PV system for ultimately their entire load requirements. And there'll be use of those storage systems to do other things like ultimately flatten out the load profile of a customer to reduce their demand charges on a monthly basis. And in fact, there's companies that are doing that right now. There's one in San Francisco called STEM that's has that as a business model, utilizing storage to ultimately help consumers even out their demands. Then we're seeing demand response being used, of course, on an ever wider scale at the wholesale level. And that's been a great success in PJM, the Mid-Atlantic grid area. They're using demand response to take up about 10% of their capacity requirements and meet 10% of those capacity requirements with demand response. That's very significant. If you multiplied that across the country, it would have a huge impact, again, on lowering the amount of central station generation, specifically peakers, that would be required to meet loads. And so we're going to see that happen as well, because it's so cost effective and it puts money directly in the pockets of consumers rather than having them pay money out to finance these peaking units that utilities have been putting in place.